So for this video, I will be doing the unboxing of Legendary Encounters Firefly. I got the chance to teach this game to people, and I don't mind teaching it some more. It's a pretty fun game. I think that's part of the thing of teaching a game, is if you like the game, then you don't mind teaching the game over and over and over and telling people this, how great this game is. And it is a pretty cool game. I liked it. It is different from the Alien and Predator games, which are also Legendary Encounter games. I think the biggest difference, I would say, is the ship. You actually play as Serenity. You don't play. Well, it's in the game. You know what? How about this? How about if I open this and then I can show you how all this thing comes together? I think that would probably be the easiest thing to do, instead of just going and say, well, you know, there's this thing right here, and there's this thing right here, and then you move this thing right here, and then you. No, just shut up and open the box. One thing I will say is that, kind of do this while opening this, is that it is for ages, what is it, 14 and up. It plays, ooh, I think I cut my box. Well, that sucks. 1 to 5 players, and you play in 30 to 60 minutes. I would say that the 30 to 60 minutes is if you do it's 2 episodes, but episode 1 is split up into 2 parts, so you have episode 1 part 1 and then episode 1 part 2, and then you have episode 3 or episode 2. When you play those 3, you can take you about 30 to 60 minutes. There are all 14 episodes in this game. You can play all 14. It might take a while, because while the episodes can go pretty quick sometimes, they can get kind of complicated, and then you're like, whoa, what just happened here? Let's slow down and take a minute. So, with that said, box is off, and this is what you see when you open Firefly Encounter Legendary. So here is the book. Let's see, what is it? 26 pages. If you are a fan of Firefly, you will very much like this, because the references. If you are a fan of Firefly, then you know what this reference is. And if you don't, just let me know, I'll tell you. This will tell you how to play the game. If this doesn't help, just let me know. I'll be more than happy to teach you, because it's what I've done already. I can teach people this game. People that I did teach it to were like, oh wow, that's a pretty cool game. It's like, yes, it is, isn't it? So I'll take out this paper. You know what, let me show you the mats, because this is the one thing I wanted to show. This is what I was trying to talk about, but not doing a very good job of it. So here you have Serenity. Now you notice you have 4 spots. If those 4 spots get filled with the ship strikes on the 5th one, you lose the game. You do have upgrades, the ship upgrades. You would do that between episodes. Also between episodes, you can heal the ship through here. If you notice, this is 1, these 2 are 1s, and here are 2s, these are credits. Between episodes, you're going to gain credits. and you can actually heal the ship or repair the ship through this. Also on here, on the ship strikes, there will be numbers between like 3 to 7. If you you can pay for it during the episode or after the episode. This can only be done after the episode. This can be done during and in between episodes. And then you have the brown coats. Brown coats cost 3, and there's cooperation. Don't get me started, because like I said, I've been teaching this for a week, all weekends. And here is the mat. There's a little shadow there. Let me try and get it out of the shadow. But there we go. So there, this is the play mat. This is where you will be playing on. So there's that, and be quiet. Let's just keep going through this. So, the first thing that we'll do is this. So this is a pack. I think, let's see, can I open this? Maybe, maybe not. There we go. About you lost me. Like a spider and just wouldn't let go. So here we have talents. So talents are another different thing that from the Alien and Predator games. They will help you each. You'll pick a character. The character will have a talent. Talents are pretty cool. So these are the talents. We go on. I'll show you later. And these are shinies. This is what you buy stuff with. Are shinies. You will get in the starting hand and starting deck. Will be 7 shinies and 5 misbehaves, and that is the next thing. The misbehaves. These will also be part of your starting deck. Next, so now we have the actual cards. That you're buying. Now here you have book, the last rites. Scoot this over. Then shepherd in the flock. Then you have Anara. Client selection. And sharing a kiss. She belongs in the bug house. From Jane. Pain is scary. From Jane. This is actually a pretty cool card, because with this one, you not only can you buy it, but if you cooperate, you actually get some attack from it. So this, I was always buying this card because this is a good, it's, for me, I was buying a lot of the tech cards because the tech cards seem to be do some pretty cool stuff. Then here's Kaylee's Space Monkeys. Then here's Kaylee's Machine Talk to Me. this is another one, and if you notice right here, you can actually repair the ship if you play a tech card. So that was actually getting a lot of these. This one, that one, and the, it's from Wash. It said, enemies do not strike on this turn. And that's also a tech card. So when you have these three tech cards, these three types of tech cards into your, in your deck that you're building, it's pretty good deck that you're building there. And then here you have Captain Reynolds. From Mal. Don't have time for this. From Mal. Then Mind Read from River. No power in the verse can stop me. From River. That was a pretty cool scene right there during the episode. That's a cool thing about this is they took like all the big moments, the interesting moments, and they turned it into a card. So, like, here's one. Another one that they did, we'll get through this, is when Book left off his hair and he has the big hair and River freaks out. I was like, oh, big hair, no, no. So it's kind of cool that they actually put those things in there. Then here's Simon, safe on my table. Then medical emergency from Simon. Sensor scan from Wash. Ah, here it is. Enemies can't strike this turn. Now, one thing, an interesting thing about this card is, I guess you could say about the whole game, is that in this game, you can take, the crew takes damage, and like you, I showed you, the ship takes damage. So when you play a card like this, neither the ships nor the players take damage. That's all enemies cannot do any strikes, so... That's a very good card to have. I like that. That's a good card. Continuing on. Zoe. If it moves, shoot it. Another enemy. Zoe. Warrior Woman. Enemies. Patience's Bandits. That's a particularly evil card. So right here, what it's saying right here is, if more than one of these is out, it will give each other a plus one. So right now this is just a four, but you add these two on the board, and now they are both five. You put another one, and they're both six. So you want to get rid of these as soon as possible. Oh, these are beautiful right here. Let me tell you. This is another one that you want to try and get rid of as soon as possible. Because with this one, when enemy enters combat zone, draw a ship strikes. It counts as if it was revealed in the combat zone. And it does say ongoing, so you do take ship strikes as it continues, as you continue playing. Because it says ongoing. So now with this card, not only do you take strikes, but the ship takes strikes too. It's pretty mean. We didn't play this one. Because this is for one of the later episodes. There's, what's it called? Badger's Game. This is another one that's in later games. Ranged. Now what ranged does in this game is that it can attack at a range. So when it would be revealed Like, there's another one that also has a range. So when it's revealed, it can start doing damage. So yeah, range is not a good thing. Another one for later on. Scavengers. And Heimer's Marshal. Another one for later on in the game. Then you have True Strikes. Now there was a lot of talk about the artwork on here, and yeah, I will admit some of the artwork isn't really that great. But when you think about it, for something like True Strikes, you don't really want pretty artwork. You do kind of want the artwork to not be as pretty, because you're taking damage. You don't want this damage. So right here you have Clobbered. We'll just say that they did it on purpose. Huh? How about that? And then Stabbed. Now these are crew strikes, and so pretty much what that means is when, let's go back a little here. So like with this one, you would be taking a strike, a person strike. What you do is this will be face down like this. So you would take this card and reveal it to yourself or to everybody else, and you see that you take 2 damage. And I'll show you more about that later. Here's Walloped. And then here, these are flaws. Flaws are an interesting mechanic in that if you've played any of the legendary games, legendary encounters, you know about wounds. Wounds are cards that go into your deck. They don't really do anything. They just kind of fill up the deck so that you, more cards are in your deck, which kind of just, it's fluff. And you don't want fluff in your deck, so it's fluff. And then every once in a while, it'll say if you have a wound, song, blah blah blah. Flaws actually do something. Flaws are bad. Because once we get to the characters, I'll show you some of the bad stuff that flaws do. And flaws will, like one card will say, add a card to the verse, which is where all the enemies are coming from, is the verse. Another one will say, Necrutin takes strikes. You take a crew strike. And the way that the flaws work is that at the beginning of your action phase, you have to play this. So if you do have 2 flaws in your deck, you have to do that flaw twice. So if the flaw says add a card to the verse, you have to do 2 flaws. If your flaw says you have to take one crew strike, you take 2 crew strikes. The good thing about flaws is that once they are revealed, once they come, you play that flaw, it goes out of the game. So you only play it once. So unlike wounds where they continue in your deck, flaws come out of the deck as soon as you play them. And and I was gonna say, I mean, if you notice, the artwork isn't that really that pretty, but as evil as these cards are, not quite sure I would really want a pretty card to do that much damage to me, if that makes sense. So there's that deck. You know, let's do this side.
Well, alrighty then. So now we have the double cross. And we here we have a crew a ship strike. So this is what you're going to be your this is how your ship takes strike. Now if you notice there's an 8 here, if you pay 8, you can get rid of this. Just like if you're buying a card, one of the regular cards. But there's also some text, so you have to do this. You have to do what this text says. There's also some cards will say ongoing. You have to do that each time it says the card would can be played. And then Jane's hats. Gotta love Jane's hat. Womack ship. So here we have one of the ships. This is for one of the later episodes, but you can see that. I mean, it doesn't cost a lot. It only takes it costs three to defeat. But if it is out, if nobody can defeat it, then your ship will be continued to keep taking strikes. When it gets to the combat zone. If the ship is not in the combat zone, you will not be taking strikes. Here's another enemy ship. No, this is a goal. So this will be like one of the objectives. Explosive charges. Enemy outlaw, Tracy. Enemy alliance, Lieutenant Womack. And of course, Womack has his soldiers. The Nady, special card. Rance Burgess, enemy outlaw. See how much it costs to defeat him? Yeah, some of these cards can get pretty big. So there is this card. I was just reading it for a moment because it's just a few little bit of text. Rance's gunman. So, let's see if I can do 3. Then the hovercraft. Fortification. Rance's ambushers. Jubal Early, one of the enemies. Oh, that's a bad one out there. Look at that. Ongoing. Players can't recruit characters. So this is something that you're going to want to get rid of quite quickly. And hopefully somebody has 6 to buy that off. Here's Early's ship. Space suit. Best go home with old Early. Does that seem right? I'm on the clock here. You ever been shot? And if you notice, it's a 12. But this is going to be an episode 14. So hopefully by that, if you do get to episode 14, you actually have, it should be pretty easy to get 12. Of course, there is some other stuff on there, so. Because it's not really an easy game. It's not supposed to be an easy game. And there seems to be thunder outside now. But yeah, it's not supposed to be an easy game. Legendary Encounter games are pretty hard. But at the same time, when you do win them, when you're able to win a Legacy Encounters game, it's like, wow, I actually won. And this is like one of the hardest games that Legendary has out right now. So if you defeat this game, yeah, I did that. So there's this one. Take on Passenger. So these are side jobs. The way side jobs work, they will be part of the enemy deck, I guess you could call it. The enemy deck has the enemy, obviously. The objective side jobs, I think they might have some of the special cards too. And so with the special job, what you're going to be doing, like what this one says, pickpocket a slave trader. So what you're going to do is when this gets revealed, it's going to be continuing down the line. If it does get into the combat zone, then you fail the mission, or you fail this side job. If you're able to complete it, then you succeed. It's just that simple. But it's not just that simple. Unification Day Brawl. Ah, yes, Unification Day. Save a dying patient. Bring medicine to a sick colony. Kind of curious. Juggle geese. Now, one thing about this game is that this game is based off the TV show, not the movie. So nothing in this game will make references to the movie, only the TV show. Pull Hall R&R. Help deliver the baby. Play Talk Hard. Shoot Hoops. Smuggle Wobble Headed Geisha Doll. Keep Jane in line. So an interesting thing about this card is that if you are playing Jane, you can defeat yourself. What this says is that some of the when we get to the character cards, they will have, if you can see right here, they will have this symbol. This is what you're going to be fighting against. If you notice from these other cards, there's these strikes, and you use strikes to defeat Jane. If you're playing Jane, you can defeat yourself. You can defeat yourself. You have to defeat yourself. If you want to finish this, then you kind of have to do that. Finish that side job. That was one side job that we did kind of put into when we were demoing the game, so it did come up a lot. Explosion. Now, if you notice right there, ship gains a strike. So not only are you taking a strike, but the ship is taking a strike too. That sucks. We had that happen quite a bit. Clobbered. Oh, there's another one. Clobbered and stabbed. Then, treatable wound. Pretty much you show your that you have a talent, and you do not take the strike. Very easy to get rid of. Electrocuted. Caught in the crossfire. Shot. But it's not all bad. Well, you know, let's do this one first. So you can see, this is an interesting one because you do not take a strike. So in a way, it's kind of good, but you and the next player in the rotation will be taking a flaw, right? So yes, if it's my turn, the person that goes after me will also take the flaw. So it's me and the person next that plays next will be taking flaw. But the good news is you're not taking a strike. Not sure if that's good or bad thing, because what if the flaw is that you do take a strike? But it's not all doom and gloom. You do have three cards that say you do no damage. So that's always good. Thank you for that. And then more ship strikes. So here's that one. Busted, yes, this one's different. Busted gravity drive. A breach. Hole in the hole. That's what it says, hole in the hole. Minor debris. Heavy magnetic interference. Ion storm. Limping. Blown engine. Smoking hot. You notice now you have a ship strike where the crew is taking damage. So it can go either way. Burning up. Drifting. Power drain. Jammed core. Heat trouble. Atmo feed malfunction. Life support failure. Monitors on the fritz. Nav calm down. Oh. And here are some of the upgrades for the upgrades. Some of the upgrades are pretty cool. So like with this one, The Luxury Cabin. And this is how much, credits. It's not buy. These are, you buy these with credits, and you get credits after the episode. Emergency Booster. Advanced Intercom System. Bigger Passenger Dorm. See, like this one, usually the bridge will hold 5 cards. With this one, now you can do 6 cards. And it only costs 1. Reinforced Hull. So with this one, instead of having 4 slots, now you have 5 slots. So on your 6th slot, you would, on your 6th strike, you would, the ship blows up. Remodeled infirmary, whatever that word is. Fire suppression system. Enhanced sensors. Armory. Internal engine stabilizers. Then a talent. And then you get these cards. These have different backs because these, when you get the, I guess you could call it the enemy deck. When you get it to, oh no, it would be a an episode. That's what it's called. It's called an episode. So the episode deck is made and it's shuffled, and you would pick one of these at random and you put it at the very bottom. And if you notice, these are the different cards. These are they inevitables? I don't know if that's what they're called. And the way that they work is that they go down, they're going down the line. They never, you cannot scan these. They get revealed the moment they come into the combat zone. Now, the moment they go and they come into the combat zone, that ends the episode, but not the game. Yes. So, that is, there's only 2 ways that the game ends, and that is with the ship blowing up, or all of the crew dying. Now, when the crew take hits, if they take too many hits, they don't die, they become unconscious. Because you can bring them back. Because since Simon is a doctor, and there are other cards that say, kill a character. Because of that, the characters do not die, they become unconscious. Now, if all the characters become unconscious, then they do die. Does that make sense? Because the game's over. If the ship blows up, then the characters do die because there's no more ship. Let's go to next deck. It is a kind of a long episode, but that's because it's like, what, I think it's like 500 cards that you can play with. And I am kind of explaining some of the rules of how to play the game while I'm doing this. So that can kind of take a while. But I kind of like to do that because I like to do that because it's a fun game. I like this game. It's a lot of fun to play. If you're a fan of Firefly, you would very much like this game. If you're not a fan of Firefly, you will like this game because it is pretty fun to play. So, more talents. Let's move some cards around here. Shall we? Yes, no? So, these are all talents. These are all shinies. These are all misbehaves. And two more last rites. Well, this seems to be the exact same as the other one. So yeah, all the other ones that we just got finished doing is the exact same thing. So let's go to another one. The sticky, sticky is sticky, sticky. Get off me, you sticky, sticky. These are the ships I recognize, because these were the ones we were looking at the whole weekend. And you notice that this is good artwork. So when people say, oh, well, the artwork is bad, blah, blah, blah. Not all of it is bad. I mean, look at that. That's pretty good artwork. So it's not... there is some good. There's some bad. Just leave it alone. Play the game. So yeah, that's the enemy strikes. So now we have the sensor sweep. Now this will be part of the episode deck. And this is kind of good because, well, if you're playing Mel or Wash, these are good because once they get revealed, it's pretty much get taken off the board. If you are not playing with Mel or Wash, then you do have to add a card to what's called the Verse, which is where the episode cards are coming from and onto. Then you have Dodson. There's a lot of words right there, but pretty much the way it works is Kaylee's going to draw Crew Strike. River, if you're playing River, then he goes in front of you, and you're that's pretty much the end of your turn, unless you can kill him for five. He will stay in front of River until you can kill him off. She cannot do anything. She cannot recruit. She cannot do pretty much anything except to kill this card. If nobody's playing River, then the person that revealed this card, it goes in front of them. So yeah, it's a pretty brutal card, but that's part of the fun, is just seeing how hard it is. And now you have Patience. Patience's biggest thing is that, for one, she costs 7, but also if you're playing Zoe, you're going to be taking a Crew Strike. And also, if you have the cards that are called Patience Outlaw, you have to kill those people first before you can kill her. And here's this dude. This is an interesting guy in that when you reveal him, he stays where he's going. He does not move from wherever it is that you revealed. But because of that, he will start striking you from where he has been revealed. He will not you will not be going into the combat zone. He will start hitting you from where he's at. Because, you know, he's a sniper. That's what he does. Then here's an enemy ship, cost 5. Yes. Each player gains a wound. If you're playing book, you gain two talents. Enemy, crow. If you draw a strike, name stab, crow strikes again. That's brutal. Dealing with Niska. So yeah, this is another interesting card. This is part of the train job. Most of the time we didn't really play up to the episode 2. We just played episode part 1, episode part 2. And people were like, hey, this is fun. I like it. Where can I get it? You can get it anywhere you want. Online or at stores. So go online or at stores and you can get your copy of this game. And then you have the Alliance Train Guards. And their big thing is you cannot steal the medical supplies until these guys are dead. And here are the medical supplies that you are trying to steal. So how will you steal the medical supplies? With this card, the Skyhook. So once this is revealed, then you can get the medical supplies, but first the guards have to have been killed. And then another enemy. Booby trap, ship strike. Enemy Alliance Patrol, enemy ship. Commander Harkin. Calm down. And 3 Alliance soldiers. Hangout. Yes. You remember that from that part in the that one show? That was, yes, Bushwhacked. And that's what I mean, that they did such a good job that you watch, that you play these cards like, oh yeah, I remember that part. So I do like how they did this. Intherton Wing. Enemy Nobleman. Badger. Yeah, nobody likes Badger. Warwick Harrow. Then 3 dance cards. The buffet table. Grange Brothers. This is after the, after this. But wait, there's more. It's after this. You get the kettle, and then you take the kettle to the planet, and then the kettle will get sick. Because the kettle is not supposed to be in space. Kettle stays on the ground. But you won't know that unless you watch the episode. So the hill people, enemy villagers. IAV Magellan. The Patron. Burn at the Stake. Dora Lee. then two scrappers. Saffron. Yeah, we remember Saffron, don't we? She was just little, yeah, you know. Scrap shop. Oh, remember that. Controls jammed. Another one. Good night kiss. Welded door. That sucks. Now you're probably thinking, you know, with all these cards, oh my goodness, how are we going to organize this? Very simple. At the very bottom, there will be the name of the episode that you're playing. So like this one, it says, Our Mrs. Reynolds. So all the cards that say Our Mrs. Reynolds right at the bottom right here, just put them together and that's your episode. For episode one, part one, just if it says episode one, part one, put all those together, that's your episode card. Those are your episode cards. Triumph Bandits. The Hero of Canton. Everybody start singing song now. You know that you want to. Magistrate Higgins. The Foreman. An Enemy Mutter. Stitch Heisen. Enemy Outlaw. Landlocked. Ship Strike. Kessler's Goods. Fess. Fireball. Distress Beacon. Sash. Open Cargo Door. SS Walden. Losing Heat and Oxygen. Betrayal. These are creepy looking guys and they have creepy looking art, so they did a very good job with the creepy looking art on the creepy looking guys. Aerial Marshals. Agent McGinnis. Neural Imager. Alliance Shuttle. The Pills. Niska's Ambushers. Niska's Boarding Team. There we go. And then Niska himself. Look at that. Look how much it cost to defeat Niska. 15. 15 to defeat Niska. That's a lot. Niska's Revenge. The Mule. Yolanda. Durin Hamer. The Lassiter. Trash unit. Haha, I remember this. An automated pickup vehicle. So we're almost done. Last deck right here. One thing I will say is that it does come with these dividers. All these are dividers that you can put in. So you can put them in the in here and divide them up as you see fits. Then it comes with six of these styrofoam things. You can use them as dividers also. Get off my finger! Thank you. So here we have more shinies. More misbehaves. One just fell down. Then the brown coats. Now all the brown coats are going to be the same thing. The only difference is this symbol right here. Now if you notice in some of the other cards, they had some text that say if you have this symbol, then you can play this. If you have this symbol, you can play that. So when you're playing, when you're getting these, these will be face down, so you can't say, well, I don't want that one. But when you do buy these, you will be looking for this. The symbol would be like, oh, hey, cool, I can actually do something with this. But they're all the same. They are they cost three with cost to cooperate. I haven't really talked too much about cooperate. Mainly because if you've played Aliens and Predator, you know what cooperate is. And if you haven't, quick way to say it. If somebody needs to buy something, then you can ask, can somebody cooperate with me? If they do have something, then they don't give you the card. That card goes into their discard pile, but they do get the rewards from that card. If you do cooperate with them, then that card goes into your discard pile, and then you get to draw another card. So you're not losing anything. They gain something, and you gain something. So it is good to cooperate. That's the whole thing about Legendary Encounters, is that it is a fully cooperative, co-op game that you either lose together or you win together. So yeah, that's the whole thing of cooperate. So here's some more book cards. Another Last Rite. Another Shepherd in the Flock. What does this thing do? Oh, that's cool. So you can activate this to defeat a flaw in any other player's hands. So there is two different types of activates. When you activate a card like this, then you just activate its card and you continue going. When you activate the ability on the character card, you are using the talent to activate that card, so the talent gets comes out of the game, but this does not. This you keep playing. Ah, here it is. Too much hair. If you're a fan of the show, you know what, you remember that scene. Too much hair. Just too much hair. That's no shepherd. And then there's that one again. And that one again. Then three. Give me this. Three ambassador cards. Playing you from the start. Done got played, son. Another. She belongs in the bug house. Pain is scary. Public relations. Vera. Everybody loves Vera. Everybody should have Vera. Space monkeys. Did another machines talk to me? Unstoppably cheerful. Look at the pretties. Captain Reynolds. Don't have time for this. Timely interruption. My kind of party. Probably remember that one too. Mind read. Yes. Mind read. No power in the verse can stop me. Looks better in red. I can kill you with my brain. That's actually a pretty good card. I kind of like that. Safe on my table. See, this is one of the coordinate strikes. So if you need one, if you're missing one to finish killing off that ship or whatever, you say, hey, I need somebody to coordinate with me, and you say, I got you. You coordinate with them, they get one strike, and you get the next card. And your next card will be this. Medical emergency. Well, I don't know, maybe. If you're playing Simon, it could be. Maymay, it's time to wake up. A moneyed individual. Sensor skin, full burn, do like this card. This is a good, let me put it like this so you guys can read it, because that's a pretty good thing that you can do with this card. And of course, you can't have a Firefly thing without having this. There was somewhere else. I think it's been in a couple of different things. Curse your sudden but inevitable betrayal. Everybody remembers this. If it moves, shoot it. Warrior Woman. Big damn heroes. Shotgun blast. So these are the avatars that I was telling you about. And actually the artwork on these are like amazing. Like they are like awesome. I mean, look at that. Look how great that those look, especially Zoe. Zoe just looks so awesome. It's just like, wow, that is great. And it's greatness in a box too. This one? Yeah. Jane. Kaylee. Inara. Book is pretty amazing too. That's like, that is Book completely right there. He even has a book too. Book with Book. How about that? Simon. And River. Now, every person is going to get one of these. When it says two to five players, each person will be grabbing one of these. We did play it where one person got two of these. If you don't play it like that, you can. If you notice, this is your health. So this is what you're trying to keep up. This is the number that you're going to be fighting against. Remember how I was saying that you're going to have to fight Jane? So let's go back to Jane here. So right here, you don't have to defeat him with 11. You just need 4. So back over here, just so happens, if I have this one out, then I can actually, let me show you here. So I can actually use this card to defeat Jane right here. And what you do, you finish the card. You finish the, it was a side job. The other thing, here are the talents and flaws. Now if you notice, it says activate and flaw, and it also says draw a card. So with the talent, you can do it two things at once or at different times, but you can do them both at the same time on your turn. So when you play the talent, you draw a card. So you can say I'm playing my talent and drawing a card. That's cool. If later on in during your turn and only on your when it's your turn, later on in your turn you need something to do to use it. So like for his, when you activate it, you get +3 attack this turn that can only be used to defeat this talent. So what it is if there's a ship or an enemy that you need an extra 3, you would take your talent and say, I'm activating my talent, and then you get the 3 to attack. Pretty cool, huh? But his flaw is just as cool, but devastating. because his is called Loyalty for Sale. So his flaw is that each other player draws a crew strike. So this is where that what I was saying, that if you have two flaws in your hand, you have to take two strikes. And it actually happened on one of my turns that I had a flaw, so I played my flaw, and then I played my talent to draw another card. That next card was a flaw, and once again I have to play that flaw, because you always play all flaws get played on your turn. So anything that you draw into your hand gets played. So yeah, there is a lot of highs and lows and yays and boos. So let's see, is this okay, let's do this first. So some more stuff here. The enemy ship for and that costs 10 to defeat. And then these are the three goals for the part one of Serenity. So you find those three cards and you finish the first episode. And then you have the Crybaby. This is a pretty neat thing, little card right there. Now this is, you know, there's an exception to every rule, right? So here is the exception to the rule. So, since it says defeat the Crybaby, the card does have to get out of the game. And then here are the episode cards. There are 14 right here for the 14 episodes. And that, my friends, is the unboxing of Legendary Encounters Firefly. I would very much recommend that you buy this, because it is a lot of fun to play. If you've played the Legendary Encounter games, you should really buy this. If you're just a fan of Firefly, then you should buy this. Because, I will admit, the other Firefly board game, it was fun, but it did kind of drag on. With this one, it's pretty quick. 30, like it says on the box, 30 to 60 minutes. And it encompasses everything in the whole thing in the whole verse, as they say on the show. There are no expansions coming out for this. Just a TV show, not the movie. And yeah, so go get it, have fun, and I'll see you guys next time.